from the floor of the CME Group. Top Notch Trading in, stepping in today for his friends from Mr. Top Step. Anyhow, it's getting to the point where it's getting tougher and tougher every day to trade something that really doesn't have an agenda. They rally him yesterday, then they take him down like crazy. We settled at 61.20 yesterday. They're over 30 handles higher at this point right now, and it's about 11:30 today. But this is what's going down. Top Notch is seeing this. They go up, make a high 94 half, go down to 89. They rally back up to 93.90. They go back down to 89. For the last 45 minutes, they're circling the wagons, but they refuse to make a new high. And these spoos are either going to do something, which could be very exhilarating to the upside, or downside, because look at selling at 61.20 and up 30 handles is a big red flag at this time. So Top Notch is looking for this. If the bonds see an offer of 122.25, they're gonna hit them down and we'll start extending higher. We'll look for 1101 half to 1103 even for first resistance with an objective today up at 1110 even. The other side of the coin is right now, one more chance of failing to make new highs in the S&P and a breach of 89 followed through the opening range of 87.5 to 86.5. Bet your bottom dollar, they'll break 12 handles like that, and you never know if we'll see yesterday settle a 61.30. There's a 70-year note auction coming out at noon. I don't really think that's gonna reflect anything with these futures, but if it does influence these 10 years into 30-year bonds, that's the key for the remainder of the day. Let's see what happens. We'll see you tomorrow. We do have the end of the month going in till tomorrow, so that's the only point that is of concern that could see a little bit more of a rally higher. But like I said earlier, they're trading with an agenda that nobody really knows right now.